The Ice House takes great pleasure in presenting Miss Lily Tomlin.
Well, thank you all a lot. How are you? Hello. Thank you all a lot for coming this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, this album is dedicated to the man who made it all possible, Alexander Graham Bell. Alex was born in 1847. Following in his father's footsteps, a renowned therapist for the deaf, Alex created lots of new techniques for treatment. For instance, every morning he would line up his patients and he would yell and scream at them, "What's the matter, you stupid idiots? Why don't you say something?" Until he'd turned purple. Then early one evening, he was flying his kite and he discovered electricity. Well, this just opened whole new vistas to him. And leaving behind his practice and several very bewildered deaf people who never did know who that man was, who was always yelling and screaming at them, he worked feverishly day and night until he'd found a way to harness electricity to a distillery for schnapps. And immediately he became locally prominent. Then, heady with success, he went to work inventing the telephone. And aided only by his faithful assistant, Mr. Watson, the magic day did arrive. With Mr. Watson in the other room, his head bent auspiciously over the sender, Alex muttered those famous words, "Mr. Watson, come here, I want you." And Mr. Watson, tears in his eyes, came rushing from the other room, his arms outstretched. And well, God only knows what happened after that. Alexander Graham Bell did kick over in 1922. I don't know if it was Mr. Watson, the schnapps, or just what. But he left behind him a monopoly, a company that has changed the history of mankind forever. One ringy dingy. Two ringy dingies. A gracious good afternoon. This is Miss Tomlin at the telephone company. Have I reached the party to whom I am speaking? Mr. Veedle? Mr. Veedle, you owe us a balance of $23.64. When may we expect payment? Pardon? When what freezes over? No. Mr. Veedle, you are not dealing with just anyone's fool. I am a high school graduate. Now then, when may we expect payment? Oh, Mr. Veedle, I don't see why you're kicking up such a ruckus when, according to our files, your present bank balance plus stocks, securities, and other holdings amount to exactly pardon? Privileged information. Oh, Mr. Veedle! Oh, that's so cute. No. You're dealing with the telephone company. For instance, as I look through your income tax return for 19... Oh, Mr. Veedle, you don't understand. We are not subject to city, state, or federal regulations. We are omnipotent. Omnipotent. That's potent with an omni in front of it. Now then, when may we expect payment? Oh, dear me, Mr. Veedle. I'm afraid we're going to have to discontinue your outgoing service. And if we do not receive payment within 10 days, we will send a large, burly serviceman to your home to rip it out of the wall. I'd advise you to lock up the liquor. He's a mean drunk. Now then... Wouldn't you rather pay, Mr. Veedle, than lose your service and possibly the use of one eye? Oh, dear me. You know, Mr. Veedle, I think we can persuade you to pay after all. I want you to listen to a little recorded conversation. Can you hear that all right? That's right, it is you. Do you recognize that other voice? That's right. And do you remember the basic content of that conversation? Wait a minute, I want to hear this part again. Oh, Mr. Beadle. Now, Mr. Beadle, if you're interested, we have 96 hours more. Oh, I think blackmail is such an ugly word. Let's just call it a vicious threat. Well, how very nice. It's been a pleasure talking with you. We will await your check. And Mr. Beadle, there's no reason on earth for you to feel personally persecuted. We may be the only phone company in town, but we screw everybody. Nuisance calls. A gracious good afternoon. This is Miss Tomlin. Yes, ma'am. You say a man has been making constant, obscene phone calls to you. What is his name and address, please? Oh, you don't? Well, just exactly what does he say when he calls? Uh-huh. Uh-huh, yes. Wait a minute now. Yes, uh-huh. What's that last part again? Uh-huh, yes. Wait a minute. He said he was going to do what to you? Wait, is that F as in Frank? Right. Well, I don't blame you getting upset. I mean, making all those promises and then not even giving his name. Hello? Gracious, good afternoon. This is Miss Tomlin, your repairs operator. Oh, Vito, hi. Oh, they've got you working today, too, so early. It's only noon. Why do those people have to have their phones fixed in such a rush? Why can't they just go to the corner and use our semi-convenient payphone? Oh, that's broken, too. Well, just what do they claim is wrong with their instrument and or service? Oh, other voices on the line. Isn't that picky? $12.50 a month doesn't buy perfection. Oh, listen, Vito. Vito, what's the house like? Where are you? In the living room? All maple and chintz? I love it. Bet it's got one of those cute little telephone tables with a special place for the directory. I knew it. Oh, well, Vito, what about the rest of the house? Well, do the Mr. and Mrs. sleep together? Well, pretend you have to check a wire. Go take a look. The county, and I work the main room. Vito, I'm here, yes. So what about the bedroom? No kidding. No wonder she's so crabby. Has she given you anything to eat yet? Not even a can of beer? Put her on, let me talk to her. Listen, you, this is Miss Tomlin with a word for you about common manners. You just listen to me and don't interrupt. Your repairman is a human being, too. And the sooner you people realize it, the quicker you're going to get your phones fixed. Now, just a second. I'm just going to say this once very clearly. You want service on your line? You want to be able to report a fire, call a loved one far away? You get your little fanny out to that early American kitchen and get Vito something to eat and drink. You got 1 minute. Now move. Vito, is she doing it? Running to the kitchen. If we play our cards right, you can have lunch there every day this week. Fix the phones, I don't know, about cocktail time on Friday. Good. Oh, listen, my board's lighting up. But if she doesn't come up with something better than a you need a biscuit and a cup of soup, you call me back. Oh, Vito, before you leave today, why don't you short sheet their bunk beds?